Hello everyone, this is Olive Branch and welcome back to Let's Play Need for Speed Most Wanted. Today I got a special guest commentator watching the video with me, so you can go ahead and introduce yourself.
Hi, I'm AAA.
Yeah, AAA is the guy who's giving me all the information on the car so far in the video, and he's joining me today because he asked me to check out the cars we're driving today. So AAA, you looking forward to seeing the Aston Martin in game today?
I think I'm going to like it.
With the CLK 500?
I don't see anything that I don't really, you know, like about it. It's very generic.
It's very generic. All right. Well, before we start, the thread voted in to sell some of these cars. They told me to sell the Mustang, the SL 500, the Lancer Evolution, and the Cayman S and the STI Impreza, because everyone said, oh no, keep all the good cars, sell all of these. And it's kind of sad because if I recall correctly, you were the one who said you wanted the Impreza to look like McRae's car, right?
Yeah.
Ah, well.
I like the blue gold outline.
Alright, well, here we are. I'm just showing off the stats for the CLK 500. People asked me to upgrade it to the new Mercedes in black, which is what we're going to be checking out right now. I don't know if I did a very good job, but this is where you come in. Do you think so?
I think it would use something a bit more VIP-ish, you know, Koenig wheels or something.
All right, well, maybe this will make you happy. It's a shame they don't have the DBS, they only have the DB9.
Well, I don't think it came out until after this game was done.
The DBS? Alright, so tell me a little bit about the DB9 then.
It's one of those cars that that comes with time.
That comes with time? What do you mean by that?
It takes a few years to, you know, get all the details done correctly. And also a bit of funding. That's where Ford came in. They actually owned this company until, 2006 or 2005. And the last car they under their supervision was this one.
The DB9?
Yeah.
Did the DBS get made by another company?
No, it just got a change of ownership.
Alright, well, I tried here to make the metallic gray of the Casino Royale DB9. I don't think it came out so well, but we can always check it out later. And first things first, I'm taking the CLK 500 into a blacklist race, because I asked you, actually, what do you think is better for the race, the Mercedes or the Aston Martin? And I think you were thinking what I was thinking, that James Bond would be better with the Pursuit.
I think that the CLK 500 is best for, you know, beach cruisers and shit.
Well, I'm showing off a lap knockout here because we haven't seen one of these in a while. And this one, apparently, this one gave me very little trouble. And if you can't tell, this is actually a post-commentary video, because I could not for the life of me find out how to stream this. But it's no big deal.
And I told him to go to the tech support to help him with the details of this video, and of course it worked.
Exactly, I was trying to find out how to sneak in the Goldfinger song there, post, you know, with all the new audio and all, and I, you know, thankfully, thanks to the LP support for it, I got my answer and the video came out pretty well, I think. So tell us about the CLK 500. You told us a little bit about the DB9. What do you think of this car?
Well, it kind of does the same job as the SL 500. It's a convertible and it's a Mercedes. Aside from that, it seems that it has a big engine, and while I do like big engines, it's not the best they can do.
By the best they can do, by the best you can do, they mean like they could have done better with this.
Well, if you called up AMG and told them, hey, we want to install a big fucking engine to this thing. Can you help us? And they will give you some 600 horsepower unit that also makes ridiculous torque.
Just watching the... Oh, by the way, if you guys are going to play this game, don't take the shortcut the PC is taking, because the CPU is taking. That shortcut is actually a dud. You might as well just follow the road, and you'll smoke the competition. Like, this lap knockout was so easy compared to the other one.
Well, it is a fast track, and it suits this car very well.
I finally activate speed brake because I figure, oh, I'm going to take this road really nice, and not really. I just smacked into the wall again.
You look like, kind of like what most people do look like when they are attempting to drift.
Especially with a car this expensive.
Well, most of them try to hit the handbrake and then they don't actually get anywhere.
Yeah, and it cost me there. This car is actually very slidey. For a moment I was afraid, but Snail back there lives up to his name, and check that out, he tries to do a shortcut and I think he completely screws up.
And that's why you don't take that shortcut. It's very easy to screw up and you don't maintain a lot of speed.
One of the downsides, I think, to the color scheme I chose for the gauge there is because you can go back to the beginning of the video afterwards and check it out, but the perfect, you know, when the needle changes color to show you're a perfect launch? If it's gray like that, it doesn't change color. You have to kind of guess it. Which kind of sucks, but what can you do?
Well, that adds to the challenge.
I know, right? It's too difficult to just nitro off the beginning. And that was a pretty straightforward win. Nothing much to it.
You could have done better.
I could have done better, I agree. I mean, maybe next time I'll do some performance tuning and get it going. And now that we've got the Aston Martin up in play, I'm going to show off here some of the challenges you have to do. We have to tag 22 cop cars. We have to get into police pursuit lasting at least 7 minutes. Dodge 10 police roadblocks. And dodge 4 spike strips. Now the thing is, the Aston Martin, when you buy a car, it's at level 1, right? So what I did was, off camera, after the dissolve here, I grind to level 3. So it's not going to take too long.
Well, good.
Suspect's driving a silver Aston Martin, traveling way over posted speed limits.
Now, if I recall correctly, you told me that, you told me earlier on Skype that Aston Martin was not a popular brand until Goldfinger from GoldenEye, or Goldfinger from 007, made it popular.
Well, it was, before that, it was more of a British car manufacturer, but it didn't become very popular until Goldfinger. They did have some racing in the 1950s, but... I don't think that matters very much to the more international audience outside of Europe.
It's got more of a status in Europe and all? Like, I don't think I've seen many Aston Martins in the United States or Canada.
I think most of the people who buy Aston Martins want it because they want to feel like Bond.
Exactly. I know, I was feeling like Bond with this.
The button that makes all the emergency lights go and think that it's something wonderful you cooked up.
Everybody wishes they had an ejector seat.
Who doesn't?
Actually, it's funny because this pursuit, actually, to get it right, took me about an hour to do. Because every time at the very last, you know, at the end of the pursuit, I kept losing the cops by accident. Or they would just knock themselves out, and I could not find a single replacement. On top of that, they would not deploy enough spike strips or anything for me to use, which was kind of shitty. I did have some good moments though in earlier pursuits, just like slamming straight into like 5 cop cars at once or something, and I was like, yeah, this would make a great James Bond moment. But there was also like moments where I just slipped between 2 police cars without even touching them, and that really made me feel like Bond.
This guy's got to pull away. Hold on.
right now my trick is to just try to lose as many cops as possible without actually evading them in order to spawn more strips. I think that's what happens. Or at least roadblocks.
I think you should have taken it that one corner a bit slower, so they will not keep up.
I'm letting them catch up. That's the thing, right? At least the advantage is that the spike strips do count as a roadblock, so if you have to do those challenges, just... And there, I forgot the speed break. So you just have to find a spike strip and dodge it properly, and it counts for both challenges. Still though, I think we're gonna, you know, I didn't cut any footage from this chase, but later on I think when we start having to block, dodge a bunch of roadblocks, it'll be tough.
Thanks, civilian.
Yeah, really? I think they put the roadblock up and that guy was drunk asleep at the wheel.
And of course, he doesn't care.
Nah, I think tunnels are a good source of blockades and all, or roadblocks. I think they spawn more often there.
I more or less use them to shake off helicopters.
Yeah, helicopters aren't too tough until you're at like heat level 5, in which case they start really getting annoying. Oh, rhinos. First time we've seen some of those in a while.
Good job, you took out the newsman.
It's gonna give him a nice story, and I think at this point I do evade them again. And I just stop to let one catch up, and I take this ramp.
Code 6, party lost.
Extremely slow.
Well, that is very unbondy.
Well, you know, it's Bond never had to do police challenges for a bunch of blacklist racers.
You never know.
You never know. It's gonna be... Oh! Yeah, Bond... Bond never went face first into the rig's wheels either.
Well, it was made not very good cinema, so...
Exactly. And this is kind of annoying. I get a face full of Rhino, and I back up to avoid them, but I found out just a moment later that it did not count as a spike strip crossing, because it did not actually cross the spike strip. So that was time wasted on my part.
It seems that the game has decided to, at the moment, to hate you a bit.
Yeah, really. Right now I'm just trying to... Just try to show off new areas, because I don't like going over the same stuff. It's fun to get some variety. And police, you know, if you're paying attention, the police are really getting more aggressive and much more skilled with their driving. Level 1, level 2, there you can brake and do kind of 180s on the spot very easily. But if you try to do that with level 3 and above, they really punish you for that.
Yeah, I have found it still to be somewhat helpful in some situations, but it takes a bit of thinking.
You finished this game before, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I actually am really looking forward to showing off the very last police chase, because when I first played it, I kept failing it so often. The police are just... I think they're heat level 6 or something. There's every single cop on the city is looking for you. But we'll talk about that when we get there. Still no single spike strips. Eventually they start throwing them at me, but...
You really need to learn how to use those brakes.
Oh, there's Bond Boulevard, speaking of. Let's go there. But the cops completely ignore me.
Something tells me that they aren't very clever.
Yeah, really, or they just saw the name. Oh, you're driving an Aston Martin, you're going to Bond Boulevard? Okay, we'll let you go, because that's pretty cool. And there I get lucky that a bunch of roadblocks just spawn up ahead. And look at that!
Nice.
Slide right. I repeated like the feat I did in the earlier video. And I don't drive so well, another news channelman killed. And I think, yeah, the backup came, so I'm back to 20 cops. Thankfully they... Nope, another civilian killed.
Try looking forward sometimes.
There's no fun in looking forward. Sometimes you just gotta close your eyes and feel the speed, you know?
Just went by me.
Oh, I can feel the speed very fine. But nothing is as fun as taking a corner at a zillion miles per hour and nailing it though.
Oh yeah, for sure. But in pursuits, you know, I can't afford to be fancy sometimes. I'm just looking forward to getting it done as fast as possible.
Roger 20, spike belt lay out to the left of the 1073.
And here the cops are just going hog wild with spike strips, and I'm obliging them by destroying their cars.
Having them do some brake dancing. And it seems that you have driven off the roadway.
I know, it's, you know, how, it's like, how often have I done that already?
Plenty.
The cops only seem to care about infractions if you do it right in front of them, which is very annoying when you're trying to get, like, reckless driving or something. Isn't that like speeding over 100 miles per hour?
It kind of depends on your car, but pretty much.
And there's only one spike strip left. It's going to take a while to get to it, though, because, again, cops being cops, they want to string out this as long as possible before they deploy it.
EA, if you're listening to this, then I would like to let you know, if you're going to put milestones into these things, then have them, the things that pop up in the milestones, pop up more frequently.
Yeah, really, I mean, it's fun when you're playing alone and trying to dodge cops. It's another thing when you're just trying to get it over with. And here I lose almost every cop, but they're very intelligent about it. Like, they're thinking, they know I'm going south, so look at the way the police cars are going. They just start converging on my position.
But you got spotted because someone was already there.
Exactly. The thing about when you're having high numbers of cops chasing you is that even if you avoid all of them, you still have like 6 or 7 or 8 or however many cops just waiting for you. One of them will spawn ahead of you and keep the chase going. Unless you manage to lose them so quickly and so thoroughly that they can't find you again. But now we're not going to lose
the helicopter.
The cops. Yeah, we're not going to lose them anytime soon because the helicopter's onto us now. I think they last for like 2 minutes or so before their fuel runs out.
He's on to me. I won't be able to get around him.
MVA indeed. Isn't that like stand for Mobile Vehicle Accident or something? Mobile Vehicle Accident? No idea. But now the cops are taking themselves out, making it easier for me. And going into Rosewood for a while because we started in downtown. I think we've hit Point Camden, the bay. And now we're here, back home, suburbia.
Yeah.
Still cops destroying themselves. Still looking for a spike strip. Still destroying poor civilians.
And it seems that the helicopter has gotten confused.
Yeah, we may have to bail on this chase.
Indeed, and there's the final spike strip. Get it over with some style.
You've gone to the block, you've gone right to the block.
Drifting right into the guardrail.
Yeah, now I'm just trying to lose them as fast as much as I'm just trying to get away. The country club is not a very good space because it's so wide, the cops can just come in from anywhere. So I just try to take these tight corners and lose them there. And thankfully, the cops can't seem to take a corner. Another spike strip, or another roadblock, but I know where I'm going. If you're trying to just rack up time, and you don't want to cheat by going to the bus station, the college campus is a very useful place to drive. Very safe place, too. And here I think, oh, I'm safe. It's all done. But a cop is already chasing me there. And he spots me while I'm trying to hide. There he is. Just have to back up, though. And there we go. The reason I'm staying out of the hiding spot is because I'm trying to get the cops to start chattering on the PA system about some stuff, but they don't do it.
Totally inconspicuous hiding.
Exactly, and then I was like, you know what, screw it, I'll just go into the hiding spot. And there's the continuation of that little theme. check out all that bounty, though. Jeez. Even before going into this, I had enough bounty to take on Ming, but they just said, no, you gotta complete milestones.
I think the Costa State is a bit conservative.
Exactly. I think so, too. Every infraction except the big speeding ones, but all the milestones have been complete. Everything's done. That's it, guys. Thanks for joining me, AAA.
With pleasure.
All right, I'll see you all next time.